Are you feeling blah, disconnected? Like you're kind of just going through the motions? In this video, I'm going to give you 3 steps to step back into your power so you can start enjoying your life again. Hello, love bugs, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, I'm Sarah, and I help teach people how to find inner happiness through fitness and spirituality. And today, I'm going to share with you how I personally stepped back into my own power using these 3 steps. First, what I want you to understand is that what you're going through is completely normal. It's something that as human beings, we all go through, including myself. The last few months, I have been feeling disconnected, lost, and because of that, I've been feeling very frustrated. I'm finding myself overthinking everything, unable to sleep at night, anxious all the time, and all around just not feeling fulfilled. So the first thing is that you want to figure out what exactly is making you feel this way. Is it your finances? Is it your relationships? Is it your health? It could be anything. What's one word that defines the issue that you're currently dealing with? Let me know in the comments below. And yes, it can be multiple aspects of your life, but right now I want you to concentrate on just one. One thing that just seems to be taking away from your life, something that is making you feel lost and confused and just all around down. Because the thing is, if we try to do everything at once, what typically happens is that it seems impossible and it seems overwhelming. And so because of that, we don't take any steps to make a change. So I want you to choose one thing, comment below, what is that one thing you want to change in your life, the one thing that you want to concentrate on throughout this video. So let's use the example of your relationship. Now it could be anyone, it could be your friends, your family, your spouse, your coworkers, your colleagues, it could be anyone. But let's use the example of a relationship. You want to dive deep into whatever it is that's bothering you. Because the bottom line is, if after being around someone or speaking to someone is making you feel down or drained or frustrated, it can be fixed. So you have 2 basic options. The first option is the one we're not really gonna talk about because it's just kind of straightforward. If you find someone constantly draining your energy and making you feel down or depressed or negative about yourself, cut that shit off. Goodbye, sayonara. See you never again, okay? And if you felt a certain way with me saying that, if you felt triggered, then the person that you're thinking about probably does need to be cut off. Now, the second way is what we're really going to get into today. And the second way is fixing this issue or fixing this reason or perception of why this person is making you feel this way. Now, this is going to take some work. You need to understand this isn't going to happen or change overnight, and it's going to take some time, it's going to take some patience, and it's going to take perseverance. You need to be dedicated to the process of fixing this relationship and fixing this situation and all around understanding yourself, and that's really what this is going to be about. A lot of times it's really easy to blame the other person, or in other aspects to blame outside circumstances for whatever situation that you're facing. But in reality, you can't fix outside circumstances. You can't change the fact that the world's shut down right now. You can't change the fact that your partner doesn't listen to you, or you can't change the fact that you're not getting credit at work if someone, your boss, isn't giving it to you. So what can you change? You can change you and your thought patterns and the way you think and the way you view things. You can change internally so that your external world changes along with it. So the first step is awareness. Sounds easy, but it's not as easy as just the word explains. I mean, you really have to catch yourself in the moment and kind of do the work when it's unexpected. You're not like sitting down and being like, okay, I feel this way, blah, 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 blah. It's like, it happens in the moment, you know? For example, you know, if you get cut off or if you're getting frustrated driving behind someone on the highway, which happens to me all the time, you have to stop yourself in that moment when you're frustrated, when you're angry, when you're annoyed, and do these exercises I'm about to share with you. The first step is to identify when your mood shifted. What happened? Where were you? What was said? What was the exact moment that you can trace back where your day went from being a decent, good, positive one to a negative one? What moment pivoted your mood? And then once you pinpoint that, you want to ask yourself, well, is this a one-time thing or is this a reoccurring event that tends to happen over and over again? Most likely, it's a reoccurring event. So let's dive into an example. So we're gonna use relationships, we'll use a romantic partner, okay? You can identify, you know, maybe you're on your drive to work and you're feeling not happy, but you woke up in a good mood. So you wanna trace it back, what shifted my mood? What exact moment did I start feeling uneasy or negative or whatever the mood is that you're feeling? My mood shifted when I noticed my partner checking out another person at the gym. Great. You've identified what the issue is and at the moment that your mood changed. And then you want to ask yourself, number two, why does this bother me? And the trick is you can't take the easy way out. You can't say because it just does or because that's who I am. That's not going to fix the issue. Those statements are not diving in deep. So then you want to ask yourself, okay, well, why did that change my mood? Why did that bother me? And then you can ask within and say, okay, well, watching that happen made me feel insecure. Then you want to go even deeper. Okay, why did it make me feel insecure? And you got to get real with yourself. You're never going to fix things and change your life if you don't get real with yourself and your thoughts and what happens internally. So you can say, it made me feel insecure because it made me feel like I wasn't good enough. Try going deeper one more time. Why did it not make you feel good enough? Ask yourself, what is my true fear in this particular situation? Then you could say, my fear is that my significant other isn't happy or satisfied with me and therefore is looking at other people because they're looking for someone better than me. Boom. You just figured out an underlying fear that you have that snowballed and evolved to this surface feeling of insecurity or jealousy or a mood shift even. And then the next step is you want to identify, where did that fear come from? Why do you even have that fear? Has this person ever done anything in the past to make you feel this way? If the answer is no, then you have to figure out, why do you have this fear? Is it something you witnessed? Maybe your mom cheated on your dad when you were younger and it tore your family apart. Maybe you were cheated on in the past and in a past relationship and it really hurt you. So let's go with the latter. Let's say my fear is due to a past relationship where I was cheated on and it really, really hurt me. So in actuality, it isn't just a mood shift. It's a deep-rooted issue that's making you feel this way because of something you experienced or witnessed in the past. So we just covered three things. When did my mood shift? Why am I feeling this way? And what is my deep-rooted fear that is stemming out of this? The deep-rooted fear that's making its way through me through this mood shift. Now, I want you to realize that this is all going on in your brain. Your partner might not even know anything's wrong. How could they know why you're upset if you don't even know why you're upset, right? And the last step, once you figure out those three things in this specific situation, you have to have the courage, you have to step up and put yourself out there and have that conversation with your partner. They have to understand why you have this fear and why you have this pain, when to them, it could be something super harmless. It could be something they don't even think twice about because they're so in love with you. But because of the things you've gone through in the past, you're all up in your head, you're freaking out, you're thinking they're walking out on you. And meanwhile, nothing's even wrong. And the thing is, guys, you can do this with everything. You can put this method through any aspect, any facet of your life. If you just take the time to do the work, ask the questions, have the awareness, you can fix everything in your life. How can you expect to enjoy your life and to be happy if you don't even know the things that are taking away from your life? You don't even know the things that are causing you pain and hurt and fear, then you can't fix it. Even though it can be easier to push the blame on external circumstances, the beauty within all of this is that you have the power. You have the power to change it. You have the power to face your fears. You have the power to design your life and your thoughts exactly the way you want them. It just takes some work, it takes some time. And sometimes you're going to face some ugly truths and dig up things that you didn't even realize were issues or fears. But the thing is once it's surfaced, once you've identified these problems and fears, you can fix them. Take your power back. Write power in the comments right now. Affirm it. Take your power back, take your life back, take your happiness back, and learn about yourself on a deeper level, because that's what's going to change your life. Thank you guys so much for spending time with me today. I loved making this video. I hope it helped you. If it did, please don't forget to subscribe and like this video. It really helps me with the algorithm on YouTube. I'm really trying to grow this channel. Let me know if you like content like this, or let me know in the comments below what you'd like to see next on this channel. I love you guys so much. Take your power back, take your happiness back. You can do it. I love you so much, and don't forget, be limitlessly yourself.